Tony Curtis for making your films, and we're about to enjoy it.
Hi, my name's Jody. I sing professionally, mostly good swing, old school stuff. Very happy to be here. Very happy to see Tony Curtis. He's fantastic.
Okay, everybody, can y'all open up that area, please?
Very attractive.
Tony Curtis, we love you.
Can I take the left side?
Hey, Tony!
Love you.
And ladies and gentlemen, the Jules Verne Festival of Los Angeles and the Historic Theater Foundation present the magic of Tony Curtis. The creators of the Paris and Los Angeles Jules Verne Festival, Jean-Christophe Joffre and Frédéric Jeudenay.
Good evening. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Because it's only the beginning, we are very happy, ladies and gentlemen, to have you here in this beautiful, beautiful, magnificent theater, the Million Dollar Theater. Just so you know, As you may know, this is Los Angeles' oldest movie palace. It was built in 1918, so we are kind of proud to be here and have you here.
And we would like, please, welcome with us to the stage the president of the Los Angeles Historic Theater Foundation. And she is a partner, they are a partner in this new adventure. We are very happy to start a new adventure here. You know that we brought the festival to the Schwann Auditorium first in 2006, then to the Los Angeles Theater last year, and then we're here at the Million Dollar Theater. We love Broadway. Please welcome to the stage the president of the foundation, Mitzi Mogul.
Welcome to the magnificent Million Dollar Theater. Built in 1918, the very first of Sid Grauman's major theater productions. We all know what else he went on to, especially up in Central Hollywood. The oldest movie palace in Los Angeles, and we are delighted to be screening old films in old theaters in order to show that they are still viable and there is still an audience for this. So thank you for helping us to prove that today.
And Curtis Lovell is here backstage. And when we talk, I said, you know, I've seen Houdini when I was a kid. Like most of you, we've been touched and fascinated, especially with what's happening at the end of the movie when he is in the water tank. So I called Curtis Lovell and said, do you do the water tank escape? He said, yes, I've been buried alive. I can escape from straitjacket. I can escape from anything. Could we do the water tank in this theater? I said, why not? Let's do it. Let's do the real Houdini thing here for you. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Curtis Lovell II.
One second.
There is someone who would like to congratulate you. It's dear to your heart. How about having Houdini, the movie version of Houdini on stage with you. Tony Curtis.
How was it like to be Houdini?
I like being Houdini. It opened up a lot of doors for me. And in those doors were all girls. I loved Houdini. Every character I've played in movies have touched me, and Houdini did. He was a great, great artist. That's the technique and the technical things are very, very important. And I practiced a lot. I understood that to become a lover on the screen, I had to be a lover in my life. All my life, I've been in the movies. I started out when I was 22 years old, after the big war. And I came out here to California from New York City. And I spent the next 50 some odd years working in the movies. What an experience. What a place to be. What a profession to have. To be able to go anywhere in the world and people would recognize you. To play all of those interesting parts I played. The magician. I played everything. Doctors, race car drivers, murderers. Remember the Boston Strangler? I did him, yes. During the making of the Boston Strangler, I wasn't allowed to go out. So I kind of enclosed in myself all the things that were necessary to make me be in the movies. I did a movie called The Great Race. Thank you. I love that movie. I was always in white, drove a nice car, had a beautiful girl. But you know, the nice thing is, I've always had a beautiful girl. And I like it. I'm a simple American boy who likes girls. You too, huh?
And Tony.
And now, before the show starts, please enjoy a montage of the from behind the scenes of your favorite movie.
Sweetness of Hollywood in those days. I loved it for that. There was a sense of revelry, but by the same token, a caring for each other, because we knew all of us were going through the exact same thing. The girls, the boys,